The other question I was going to ask, the shot on 12 obviously was a big shot. What was your thought process lining that up? I mean, you're just trying to get close. I mean, what was your strategy there?
Yeah, well, I was definitely disappointed that I missed the green, but it was a difficult tee shot. And so when I got over the chip shot, it wasn't a great lie. And so we, you know, paced out where I wanted to land it. Britt was like, it would probably come in a little bit lower, not as much spin just because of the lie. So I was just trying to make, you know, solid contact, landed on my spot. And then, you know, to have it go in was definitely a big bonus. It was going pretty hard. So it was definitely a huge momentum change. And, you know, it was a huge point in my round today.
Which did you like better, that one or the one on 18 where you got out of the gully?
Yeah, the 18 was definitely very clutch. That is not where I wanted that tee shot to be. So to be able to get up and down there for the win was really cool, especially after Jessica, you know, made such a great shot and put a lot of pressure on me to make par.
Okay, I'll let other people ask questions. Thank you, and congratulations again.
Thank you.
Beth Ann, you're next.
Hi, Brooke. Congratulations. Two from me, if I could. That shot on 18 was amazing. But I want to ask you about your putting. You mentioned yesterday after the round that you felt a lot more comfortable with your putting. Can you just say specifically what it is that you and Brittany have worked on? I know you've changed your grip, but what has been the most impactful change for your putting?
It's continuing to be a work in progress, but definitely this week felt a lot more comfortable. Even today, I made a lot of great putts, and even the ones that I didn't make, I still felt like I hit it where I wanted to, which was a great feeling. As you mentioned, we've worked on grip, we've worked on different reading techniques. We're just trying to find, you know, what's working the best. And to be honest, it's just the extra time that we've been putting in. I think that's made the biggest difference. And you know, that extra time has given us some extra confidence. And you know, for me, just over putts now, I feel like I can make them, which is how you want to feel when you're putting. And so I'm just grateful that we're able to, you know, figure it out. And like I said, it's a work in progress. So I'm just always trying to get a little better.
And then the folks back home in Ontario aren't able to play golf, so I'm sure they enjoyed watching you win. what's your message to them, and would you like to see the golf courses opened at home?
Yeah, you know, I think golf is a great way to be outdoors and get some exercise, and it's really unfortunate that they are shut down right now. Hopefully they'll open up sooner than later, because I think it's you know, a great way to, like I said, get exercise, get some fresh air, and also have a little bit of social while doing it pretty safely.
Thank you, Brooke. Congrats again.
Thanks, Beth Ann. Next is Kent Paisley. Okay, we're going to go to Adam next.
Awesome, thanks. Hey, Brooke, congratulations, way to go.
Thanks.
Obviously, in your interview right after the win was confirmed, you had a little emotion kind of brimming to the surface. Where did that really come from? Was it just the fact that you managed to take a win across the finish line after a couple of years? Where was that emotion kind of coming from, and how did it kind of bubble up to the surface there?
Like I said, you know, I felt like I've been playing really solid golf, and just haven't had the victory in what feels like a really long time now. I guess it wasn't really that long considering last year, most of the season we weren't playing, but just to finally, you know, get it across the line and to have, you know, the work that Britt and I've been putting in pay off and just be able to celebrate together and get the 10th win on the LPGA Tour is really incredible. And I was just really happy and just really excited.
And just a quick follow-up to build off what you just said, you know, 10 wins on the LPGA Tour. How does that feel?
Yeah, unreal. It's pretty crazy. You know, to get my 9th win was such a big deal in Canada, record breaking. And then, you know, since then I've been just trying to chase that 10th one, and to get it here, it's just, I'm just so happy, and it's hard to believe.
Awesome. Thank you. Congrats again.
Thanks, Adam. Is anyone else eager to ask questions? Please utilize the chat function. Okay. Last chance for anyone to ask any questions.
Hey, Paul, it's Bob Weeks here. Can I do my one-on-one after, right after this?
Yes, we're gonna finish up this press conference and then we will let you get your one-on-one, but Beth Ann has another question.
Brooke, hi again. I apologize, I know you've probably talked about this a lot, but choking down on all your clubs, just for the viewers at home who are watching, why do you do that and how does it help?
Yes, so I've actually done it since I started playing the game when I was like 3 or 4 years old. I just started out that way and got really comfortable. And, you know, a couple years ago, I thought maybe I would try to grip like a normal person at the end of the grip. And I just wasn't as, well, number one, comfortable, and number two, not as accurate. So I think, you know, by choking up, I do lose a little bit of distance with my irons, but I think I make up with it. For inconsistency and accuracy, and just overall the being comfortable.
So your driver's longer than regulation, right? But your irons, are they normal?
Yes.
Okay. And how long is your driver?
48.
48 still. Okay. Perfect. Thank you. Congrats again.
Thanks.
Okay. I think Kent has a question. Kent, if you'd like to unmute yourself.
Hey, Paula, Brooks, sorry, can't hear me. Not the internet's not great currently, but you mentioned at the Lotte Championship that you need breaks to win. What do you think was your biggest break today?
Yeah, I definitely am a firm believer. When you're in the winner's circle, you're getting a lot of breaks and it's just sort of meant to be. And, you know, today I was making a lot of birdies and then I think probably the biggest break was 12, that chip in. And, you know, those breaks can be like really small or they can be really big. You know, sometimes it's just missing a divot or today I had tons of opportunity where the people I was playing with showed me the line on putts. They're always, it's just a little bit behind me. So I always had a read on like every green and that just only happens when it's meant to be.
What did you think about walking past the Canadian flag on the 8th of the tournament? Do you think they should rename it in your honor after your win?
The Canadian flag. Yeah, that was pretty cool. I guess it's the consulate. So it's like a little piece of Canada right here in LA.
All right, thanks so much, Kent. We've got one question for me. You got 3 weeks off, Brooke. What are you most looking forward to doing? And not many players who've won this year have been able to celebrate, but what are you going to do to celebrate?
Yeah, it kind of worked out really nicely that we decided not to go to Asia. So now I have 3 weeks off, spend it in Florida with my sister and brother-in-law. And I'm sure we'll come up with a few great ways to celebrate. But I'm definitely looking forward to some time off and then, you know, just practicing and getting ready for the rest of the season.
All right, and my last question is just for all of the little girls out there watching who are such big fans of your game, just what message do you have for them when thinking about little Brooke?
You know, this game is incredible and it gives you so many great opportunities and, you know, the friends that I've made and the places that I've been able to travel are really crazy and it's just, I'm really grateful that my parents got me into the game and that my sister and I have been able to share this journey together. So I think, you know, it's just really important to have fun and whatever you choose to do and have somebody that you can share the journey with because it makes it that much more special.